They were not serious. They're like, oh, yeah, some rich NBA player wants to do music. All right, cool. But when I actually, yo, yeah, I got this, I got that, I got that, they're like, okay, he's not playing. He's serious. I'll be in the studio with artists, and I'll play that first beat, and they're like, oh, you actually make beats. So these are actually good. Like, yeah, like, I'm actually good at this. Even in seventh grade, me and my friends, we had a rap group. We would go to the lunchroom and take a pen and our fist and beat on the tables and freestyle and just have fun. So I've always had a passion for music and making beats. As soon as I got to college, I took a $10,000 loan. I went and bought me a laptop. Then I downloaded FL Studio and I started making beats. Probably been doing it for about 10, 12 years, and it started to actually pick up the past 5 years, I would say. It's definitely connections and who you know when it comes to music. Rather than basketball, it's are you good? All right, go play. But in music, it's more who do you know and how can I get my song here or my beat here and meet with this person and that person. It's a lot of networking. For example, I had a Justin Bieber placement on his album, and that was from a relationship with Justin Bieber's writer that I had met 7 years prior. Get in the studio, I'm playing samples for him, just stuff that I've been messing with. She's like, stop. All right, let's work on that one. The engineer puts it in the computer, and we're just writing to the song. He took that song, he showed it to Justin. Justin's like, I like it. A month and a half later, he calls me and was like, you made the album. Oh, yes, I am. I have a crazy catalog of artists that I've worked with, and I'm not even full-time in it. So I'm like, damn, if I was actually full-time in it, I would probably do tenfold what I'm doing right now. This studio space is definitely a safe haven for me where I can come in and just create my own sound and have my own brand of what I do to where when you hear it, you're like, oh yeah, that's a JaVale McGee beat.
Pierre Music.
My first tattoo was the basketball on my chest being held by God's hands with a cross and my grandma's name written on it. It's actually a good tattoo though. Like after I see a lot of people's tattoos, I'm like, that was a high quality tattoo that I got in college. My father's name is George Washington Montgomery III. So rather than get a picture of him, I got that tattoo. When I look in the mirror, I see the tattoos on my chest are the names of the people in my life who really influenced me and helped me get to where I needed to go, especially my mother. My mother's a giant part of my success in basketball. She was my coach. She had me running around this high school in Flint in 0-degree weather in Timberland boots. And every time I come back around, she'd be like, you gotta work hard. And when I come back around, she's like, you never gonna quit. So she just constantly was on my ass about stuff like that. And when I got to the league, I was like, okay, it's time for you to just be a mother now. You don't need to be a coach anymore. My arm tattoos are really just about art and just, I feel like, life experiences. I made sure that I got a lot of things that I'm really passionate about, which is just art, a statue of David. Sometimes I feel like life is about fighting that Goliath and just making it out in the end. Monopoly's always been my favorite game in life. Buy property, collect rent, and that's how you're supposed to live life. That's how the wealthy get wealthy. And I had no idea while I was playing the game. Then I'm like, why do I love this game so much? And then as I got older, I'm like, oh, wow, because it's literally life. I saw a picture of the It balloon, and I was like, this is so beautiful. I took it to my tattoo artist, and I was like, I want this. I didn't realize that all this black was gonna hurt as bad as it did. In the end, it was worth it because it's a beautiful tattoo. In 2014, and I had a stress fracture in my shin. I was out of the league for about probably 6 months to a year. After my surgery, I was like, I'm gonna get an eagle rising and a sword on the side of it because I have a rod in the middle of my shin. It's a career-ending surgery. I was just trying to make sure that I stay motivated and that I still rise like an eagle. The artwork is extremely important. I definitely want it to look good all the time. In the sun, it's the summer, you vibing. You can't be looking good when your tattoos are all ashy and looking dull. So the Mad Rabbit Aftercare Balm, just putting that on my tattoos and making sure that they really pop. It definitely prevents it from fading. Personally, I'm always worried about what's organic and what is this made of. So the fact that it's organic and all natural is definitely good. I'm really excited about it.